Yes, children, a very happy morning to one and all here. So I hope all are listening to me. Good morning, children. Okay, thank you. Yes, in today's class, we're going to talk about a lesson which talks about the wisdom. Children, do you all know what is the meaning of wisdom? Wisdom means knowledge. You have some knowledge and you are utilizing it to give a good judgment to somebody, or you have having a good knowledge of judging people, okay? Or you can say being wise means you are clever, you are intelligent, okay? Now the name of the story here is The Boy Who Sold Wisdom. The name of the lesson is a little peculiar, you feel. What is this? Selling wisdom? How can you sell her wisdom? Okay, now we will have an interesting topic. We will learn what exactly he is selling. Okay, children, the name of the lesson, The Boy Who Sold Wisdom. Okay, yeah, it is prose 2, page number 11. Okay, yeah. Nagendra was orphaned and found himself without a job. He was clever and he had learned many things by observing his father. Means Nagendra was an orphan. Means now Nagendra is orphan. Before, when he had his father, he learned many things from his father. One day he had a brilliant idea. What idea, children? Brilliant idea. He went into a town and hired the smallest and cheapest place he could find and set up a shop. So what idea he had, children? He got a very brilliant idea that he can go to the town and see for some small and cheapest shop for a rent. He went into the town and hired the smallest and cheapest place he could find and set up a shop. So he wanted to have a small shop. He spent a few nickel coins he had. Nickel coins means, children, in those days, you know, they used to have a silvery white metal. Like most of them, those days, in those generation, everyone used to have lot of nickel. So now he says he had, so he sold a silvery white metal. Okay, so he spent a few nickel coins he had, means he gave the few nickel coins, on paper, ink and a pen. Over his shop, he put a placard that said, means now he got one nice, small, a cheapest rent shop he found, okay? So now in that shop, he put a placard. Placard means in a small card he has written. What has he written? Wisdom for sale. That is the name of the lesson here, okay? Wisdom for sale, he has written in the placard. But here he sold wisdom, okay? All around him were merchants who had large shops. They sold clothes, jewelries, fruits, vegetables and things that people brought every day. So here what happened? Now Nikhil, he opened a nice small shop. But the name of the shop was what? What was the name of the shop? Wisdom for sale. He put a small placard and he hung in front of the shop. So beside the shops, what had happened? Vegetables were there. I mean, the merchants were selling vegetables, fruits, groceries, different things. But this Nagendra, what he was selling? He was selling the wisdom. Nagendra called out all kinds of wisdom for sale. Nagendra started calling out all kinds of wisdom for sale. All kinds of wisdom for sale. Usually in the, like if you go to the market, they will call, no, tomato, potato, 10 rupees kg, tomato, 10 rupees kg, like that. Here, Nagendra started to call, saying, all kinds of wisdom for sale, reasonable prices. The people who had come to buy things could not see anything in the shop, but could only hear the words he was shouting. Children, in the as there was a many vegetable shop and many merchants were there and people were walking around, they just, as he was, Nagendra was calling out all kinds of wisdom for sale, and they could, they just keep like this, they could not see anything in the shop except his sound, except his tone. They crowded around and laughed at him. So all the people, what is this? Nothing is there in the shop, but still he is shouting wisdom for sale, wisdom for sale. What is this? And people started to laugh. No one bought even one piece of wisdom from him, but he was patient. Now the here, we find, what is this wisdom he is selling? Now let's see the next interesting topic, what he says here. Yes. One day, Bapu, a rich merchant's son, happened to pass by and heard the wisdom selling hawking his wares. Now what happened? The next character here, Bapu, that is, he was a rich merchant, his son, as he was passing by Nagendra's shop, he could hear what is this wisdom and all that. So now what happened? Wisdom of all kinds. He was a stupid boy. He didn't know what was really being sold. He thought it was a vegetable or a thing he could hold in his hand. So now, as Bapu was a merchant, rice merchant, his son, as he was passing by, he could hear some wisdom. But this Bapu's son was stupid. He did not understand anything about the wisdom. He just thought it may be some vegetables or fruits, and he just went into his shop. Okay, then what happened? We will see. He did not know what was really being sold. He thought it was a vegetable or a thing he could hold in his hand. He thought, okay, I can hold something in my hand and go. He thought it is something like that. So he asked Nagendra what it would cost per kg. Nagendra said, I do not sell wisdom by weight. I sell it by good quality. He says, I don't give any of my wisdom in the weight. I give it as a good quality. I sell it by quality, he says. Bapu put down a nickel and asked Nagendra to give him her nickel's worth of wisdom. The boy took out a piece of paper and wrote on it. Now what happened? Even Bapu, he gave a small piece of nickel to Nagendra and he said, you give me something. You give me a wisdom. Whatever you are selling, you give me. Because Bapu's son, he was a stupid boy. He didn't understand what is wisdom. So now what did Nagendra did? Nagendra took a small piece of paper. We'll see what he did. He took out a piece of paper and wrote on it, it is not wise to stand and watch two people fighting. What did Nagendra write in a small paper? He wrote, it is not wise to stand and watch when two people are fighting. And he asked Bapu to keep it tied in his turban cloth. You know, in those days, they used to wear a turban cloth around their head. So now here, Nagendra told Bapu, Bapu's son, put it inside the turban and tie it. Bapu went home and showed his father what he had brought, what he had bought. He said, I bought some wisdom for a nickel and I have it here tied up inside this turban cloth. Now what happens? Bapu's son goes to Bapu's house and says, I have given a nickel to one of the person there, and I brought something, and it is on my head. It is tied on with a turban. Now here he says, I bought some wisdom for a nickel, and I have it tied up inside this turban cloth. Now he says, I have put that inside the turban cloth. The father untied the knot, means the father removed the knot, looked at the scrap of paper and read what was written. Now father removes the turban and he opens, he finds a small piece of paper, and he started to read what was written in the paper. It is not wise to stand and watch two people fighting. Now what happened here in the paper, what he had written, it is not wise to watch two people fighting. I repeat, what was written in the paper? It was not wise to watch, and it is not wise to stand and watch two people fighting. Means when two people are fighting, it is not good to watch at them. He was furious. Furious means, what have I given? Furious means extremely angry. Means who was angry? Bapu was very, very angry. For this paper you gave a nickel. So now he says, he was furious. He screamed at his son. Means he started shouting at his son, you fool, paying a nickel for this nonsense. Means you have given for this small paper, for this bit of paper, you have given a nickel. Everyone knows you should not stand and watch two people fighting. He says, what is this in the small paper? He has written like this message, that everybody knows the message, that when people are fighting, you should not stand and watch. He says that everyone knows it. Then he went to the marketplace and stormed into Nagendra's shop and scolded him soundly. Now what happened? Now Bapu went near Nagendra's shop. Very angrily he went and stood in front of him. And what did he say? We will see. Okay. You scoundrel. He got so irritated, so aggressive he became. And he said, you scoundrel, you have cheated my son. He is a fool. Mean my son is a fool. And you are a cheat. He says, my son is a fool and you are a cheat. Return to nickel or else I will call the police. Now he will say, whatever my son has given you as a nickel, please give it back to me or else I will call the police. Nagendra said, if you don't want my goods, you can return it. Give me back my wisdom and you can have your money back. Now what Nagendra is very polite and he says, if you don't want my goods, please you can take it, but you have to return back my goods. Now he says, Gupta, the merchant, threw the scrap of paper at the boy and said, there. Now he says, he scraps the paper, what he had written the message, he scraps the paper and throws it and he says, there, take it, give back my money. Now give me back my money. Nagendra said, no, you have not given me back my wisdom. Now here the Nagendra is telling, you have just thrown the scrap paper on me, but you did not give me the wisdom. You will have to sign a document saying that your son will never use my advice. Now here Nagendra says that you have to sign in a document saying that my son will never take my advice, that is Nagendra's advice, to not be taken. Nagendra tells Bapu, I repeat, Nagendra tells Babu, you have to sign in a document that my advice should not be used. And he will always stand and watch people fighting. And he says, and this advice should not be taken by your son. The passerby supported Nagendra. So Gupta readily signed the document and took his money. Now what happened? As the passerby and all were there, they all supported Bapu And so Bapu signed in the document saying, okay, my son will not take up your advice. He was happy. Who was happy? Now Bapu is very happy that he got back his nickel. He was happy that he had been easy to undo his son's foolish bargain. Now he felt that, okay, he finished his job without anything bargaining. He has done his job. He has got his nickel and he left. Few days later passed. The king of the land had two queens who hated each other. Now what happened? Now here, the king and there were two queens, and at the same time they were also having two males, but they were not at all getting on together. They used to always have a clash. They never get on with each other. Even it happened with the maids too. The maids too were also quarreling like the two queens. They quarreled as bitterly as their mistress. One day, each queen sent her maid to the market. The maids went to the same shop and both wanted to buy the same pumpkin. What they wanted to buy? They wanted to buy the pumpkin. Now these queens sent their maids to the market and they wanted to buy a pumpkin. You all know what is a pumpkin, the big huge vegetable. They wanted to buy a pumpkin. So unfortunately in that shop there was only one pumpkin, but these two people wanted, that two maids wanted each pumpkin for them. But they did not find two pumpkins, there were only one pumpkin. There was only one pumpkin. So they begin to quarrel. Now here, even in the market also, they started to fight. Who? These two maids started to fight. The abuse and gestures were so fierce that the grocery fled the place. Means here, as these two were fighting, these two maids were fighting for the pumpkin. What is the meaning of abuse, children? Abuse means to shout at somebody angrily. When you are very angry or when you are very much aggressive, that is abuse, okay? Cruel and violent treatment of a person. So now these two maids started fighting because of the one pumpkin. And what happened here? The merchant flew. Flew means here, fleed means flew. Run away from the place. Now because these two maids were fighting, he could not tolerate that fight and he ran away from that place. What happened to be nearby remembered his father's contact with Nagendra and went there to watch the quarrel. Now what happened? Now here comes about the Nagendra and Bapu's son story. Look, please listen carefully. One day, each queen sent her maid to the market. The maids went to the same shop and both wanted to buy the same pumpkin. There was only one pumpkin, so they began to quarrel. The abuses and gestures were so fierce that the grocer fled the place. Means, as I told you, the grocer went off from that place. Bapu, who happened to be nearby, remembered his father's contract with Nagendra. Now here what happens? Bapu, who happened to be a nearby, remembered his father's contract. What was his father's contract here? What was the advice given by Nagendra? You should not watch when two people are fighting. You should not stand and watch two people are fighting. Now here, as these two maids were fighting, now comes up the story. Nagendra and went there to watch the quarrel. Okay, now he went there to watch the quarrel. The maids fought, tore each other's hair and came to blows. One of the maids noticed that merchant's son and said, "You be my witness. She struck me." The other maid cried, "You have seen with your own eyes who struck whom. You are my witnesses. She had hit me so many times." Then they remembered other errands and went their ways. Means other mistakes, and they went their ways. Now what happened here was, as these two maids were fighting, that is Nagendra, as these two maids were fighting. Now, who has seen the fight? Yes, now Bapu has seen the fight. Who has seen the fight now? As these two maids were quarreling, Bapu came across and he was watching their fight. And in that, one queen observed that this Bapu has been watching their fight. Now they go to Bapu and tell, Bapu, you were the witness. You saw the fight. Who started first? Who started first? They started questioning him again and again. And also they told who cried first, who beat first, who tore their hair first. So now Bapu was confused what to do. And he's like, what, why people are doing like this? The two maids went to their queens and told them about the quarrel. Now it was time for them to go home from the market. So they went to the home. And as soon as they reached home, they spoke to the queen, said like this, all these things happened in the market. That is, the quarrel happened in the market. Adding all sorts of colorful details. The queens were not furious and sent complaints to the king. Each of them sent word to Bapu that he was the witness on her side. Now both the queens went and told the king, she quarreled. Finally, they said that there was one person who saw us fighting. That was Bapu. Each of them sent a word to Bapu that he was the witness. Now they told there was one person who saw a witness. That was Bapu. If he did not speak in support of her, she would have his head chopped off. Bapu was in panic. Now the queen goes to Bapu and tell Bapu, you should speak in favor of me. You should not tell that I only beat her or she beat me. You should not tell like that. You should be the favor for me. If you are not the favor of me, they will chop your head. Now here, Bapu was panicked, means he was worried. He was confused what to do. Finally, the son said, let's go and ask Nagendra. Now what happened? All the story, this Bapu's son transferred it to Bapu. Now Bapu was like more afraid. Oh my God, my son will be chopped now. What should I do now? Then what he thinks, okay, let me take an advice from Nagendra. Now again, Bapu goes to Nagendra and he tells all the issues. Now this had like two queens were fighting and they had observed that my son was observing their fight and now they're calling him for the witness. So where he goes? He goes to Nagendra. Finally, the son said, let's go and ask Nagendra. He has wisdom to tell. Let us see what he has to say to get me out of this crap. So father and son went to Nagendra, who said he could help, but the fee would be 500 rupees. Now what happened? Bapu goes to Nagendra and says all this problem to him. And Nagendra will not deny him. He will help, saying, I will help you, but you have to give me a fees of rupees 500. Gupta paid him the money, and Nagendra said, now Gupta very quietly gave 500 rupees to Nagendra. When they called to the court, pretend to be incensed, behave as if you understand nothing of what they said. Now here, so beautifully, Nagendra has given a message. See, you be very quiet. Don't pretend as if you have understood the quarrel. This was a very beautiful advice given by Nagendra to Bapu's son. Now Bapu's son was taken to the court. Now next day, the king called the witnesses. Now here Bapu's son comes for the witnesses. He and his ministers asked Bapu various questions, but he could not answer any of them. So now what he was pretending and how he was pretending. Here Bapu's son was pretending as if he doesn't know anything, and the minister was asking him lot of questions, different questions, whereas Bapu's son, he was only pretending and he was not even answering to any of his questions. He merrily blabbered and uttered nonsensical syllables till the king lost his patience. Now the king is sitting also and watching what is happening, but even then he did not give any of the answers and drove him out of the courtroom. So now here king has lost his patience. Now he says, you please take him away. Bapu was delighted, means he was happy that he is safe in the, he has come out of the safe. He is now into the safe zone, means he is happy that his head is not being chopped. Bapu was delighted, means he was happy by the success of the ruse. He told everyone about Nagendra's great wisdom, which soon became a buzzword in the marketplace. Now Bapu's son started intimating to everybody, saying that I used his wisdom and I was in the safe zone. Now Gupta was not pleased. Means Gupta, he was still not pleased. He saw his son would have to feign madness always, or else the king would find out he had been tricked. He would certainly chop off his head if he found out. So back they went to Nagendra for more wisdom. For another 500 rupees, Nagendra advised them, go back to the king when he is in a good mood. Now here Gupta was not satisfied. Now here again Bapu goes to Nagendra. Again Bapu goes to Nagendra and asks, now maybe again they may call my son for the witness. Now how should he answer him in case if they ask him for the second time? Now I am very scared about my son. So now what here Nagendra gives the advice again is, he says, so go back. They went to Nagendra for another 500 rupees. Nagendra advised them, go back to the king. What did Nagendra advise again? He said, go back to the king when he is in a good mood. Tell him the whole story. Now Nagendra is telling to Gupta's son, see, you go and see the king. If the king is in the good mood, you tell him the whole story. You tell him the truth, what had happened. He will find it amazing and he will forgive you. Now here Nagendra is telling, king will definitely feel that you are amazing and he will give you a amazing ice. He will relieve you from that place he will tell. But make sure he is in a mood of laughter. But here Nagendra is telling, please make sure that the king is in a good mood, and only when he is in a good mood you go and tell him all the truth what has happened. And so Bapu followed the advice, found the king in a merry mood. So now Bapu went again and he also found that the king was in a good mood and told him the story. The king laughed a lot and forgave him. So the same thing what the Nagendra's advice was there, he also followed and he gave a laugh. Then the king, who was intrigued by what he had heard of Nagendra in the market, sent for him and asked if he had any more advice to sell. I repeat, then the king, who was intrigued by what he had heard of Nagendra in the market, sent for him and asked if he had any more wisdom to sell. The boy said, of course, I have plenty to sell, especially to the king, but my fee would be 100,000 rupees. The king paid him the 100,000 and the boy gave him a piece of paper on which he had written, think deeply before you do anything. Now what had happened? Now here Nagendra becomes famous. Now here Bapu reveals about Nagendra's advice. Now here the king says, oh my God, who is that? I want to visit. I want to see who is that Nagendra now. So now the king goes to Nagendra and he says, Nagendra, I want you to advise me. So Nagendra, he will not deny. He will say, okay, I will advise you. But for you, the fees is, how much is the fees? You would have to pay me 1 lakh. That is 100,000 rupees. The king agrees and he pays that money. and what is the advice he gives to the king? Think deeply before you do anything. What advice Nagendra gives to the king? Think deeply before you do anything. The king was so delighted with the advice that he made it his motto. Now the king accepted so beautifully because the advice was so effective. What was the advice, children? Think deeply before you do anything. This was the advice given by Nagendra. He had it embroidered on his pillow and engraved on his cups and plates so that he could not forget it. So, you know, he could not forget it. So now what happened? He has to remember this. Think before I do something. He has to remember. So wherever he found the place, he started to write. Wherever he saw, wherever he feels that, okay, this place is a nice place, I have to write so that I will remember. I keep looking at this place so that I will remember that phrase. Think deeply before you do anything. The king was so delighted with the advice that he made it his motto, and he had it embroidered on his pillow and engraved on his cups and plates so that he would not forget it. So as I told you, he has written in few of the places where he wouldn't forget the phrase. Some months later, the king fell ill. What happened? Now after few months, the king, he fell sick. The minister and one of the queens had been conspiring to get rid of him. So they bribed the doctor and persuaded him to poison the king's medicine. Now these queens, what they thought, they wanted to do something bad for the queens. What they had thought was they wanted to do something bad for the king. So what did they do? Let us see. When the medicine was brought to the king and he lifted the golden cup off his lips, he wrote the words engraved on it. Now what happened? When the doctor came to see the king, as he was sick, he has come to give the treatment. What happened? The queen told that in the medicine, you add the poison. In the medicine, you add the poison and give it to the king. So now what happened? The doctor also listened to the queen and he mixed the medicine. He mixed the poison in the medicine and he gave it to the king. And when the king was about to drink the medicine, he felt the advice of a beautiful person, Nagendra. What was Nagendra's advice? Think deeply before you do anything. That phrase came to his mind. When the medicine he brought to the king and he lifted a golden cup to his lips, he reads the word that engraved him, means that motivational words he's reading. Think deeply before you do anything without suspecting anything he thinks. He thought about the words, lowered the cup, means he brought the cup down and looked at the medicine in it. The doctor, who was watching all this, felt nervous. Now as he was drinking, he sees the phrase in front of him. So he slowly brings the cup down and he looks at the doctor. He thought about the words, lowered the cup and looked at the medicine in it. The doctor, who was watching all this, felt nervous. Now the doctor is very scared. Oh my God, did he get to know that the medicine is mixed? He feels that his conscience says that, did the king get to know the action? The doctor threw himself at his feet and confessed to everything and prayed to be forgiven. But the king ordered that the doctor must be arrested. Now as he puts the cup down, he looks at the doctor and doctor feels really bad and he comes to his I think he comes to him closely and he says that, please, I'm very sorry, kindly forgive me. Now the king will not accept his sorry. He will tell the doctor should be arrested. He sent for the minister and the queen and insisted that they drink the poison in his cup. They too fell at his feet and begged for mercy. And now hear what happened. Who's the main cause for all this medicine, poison and all mixed? It is the queen. So now he says the queen should drink the poison. So now what these people do, they come and fall on his feet and they say, please forgive me, I am sorry. They begged, means they were asking, please forgive me, please forgive me. He ordered them to be hanged. Now finally the king says, no, you people should be hanged because of this very bad nature. And he banishes the doctor from his kingdom. He made Nagendra his minister and honored him with wealth. Now who has become, he made Nagendra his minister and honored him with wealth. And he called Nagendra and he honored him and he said this. Okay? Children, I hope you understood this. Let me have a recapitulation. Okay? The meaning of nikis is a silvery white metal. And what was the role of this? That is a silver metal. Firstly, he gave it to the Nagendra and he brought the first piece of advice. And furious means extremely angry. You are very angry about something. Abuse, to use bad languages or to shout at somebody. Cruel and violent treatment of a person. Fleet and flew, run away from the place. When was this word used? When the two queens were quarreling, the grocer, he just left, he just flew that place. Now these were the characters used in the story. Nagendra, a very important person in the story, and what he used to do, he used to sell wisdom. He was the main character in the story. And then Bapu, he was a rice merchant, and his son, Bapu's son was stupid and he was never clever. So he went to Bapu's shop and he went to Nagendra's shop to buy a small piece. He was asking, give me whatever you are selling, give me. Then Nagendra tells, I am not selling anything, I am selling a quality, that is the wisdom. He says that. And here the king, you know what is the role of the king? And two queens were always quarreling, and they were never getting on to each other. And the two maids were just like the two queens, always fighting with each other, and the minister and the doctor. These were the characters used in the story. I hope it is clear. Thank you.